primary 5 from Edmund Primary School.
My name is Kunze, 8 years old, primary 2, also from Edmund Primary School.
This lesson is
calculus,
chapter 5, indefinite interval. For this question, we have already used 3 methods, right?
Yes.
So this time we'll use the 4th method. For this 4th method,
it is complex number by inverse function.
First we can factorize.
Yes. After that we'll split.
Which is the partial fraction.
Yes.
Then we can integrate using the formula.
Sacco cosa?
Okay, for this example, you can write.
But cannot. Because we didn't separate the real number and the imaginary number.
Okay, well, can I give an example for this?
Yep. 3 plus 4, I?
For example, this, right? This is actually this part. Am I right?
Yep. Yes, that is 8 squared.
Like this? This is a minus b squared. Like this. So this part is the real part. Here is the imaginary part. Okay, this part, you know, it's real, right?
Yes. So we need to, so was x squared minus y is the u. And actually, you can write it in another
way. Okay, let me ask you, for this v x plus y, is it real?
Vx,
for this part?
Yes.
Yes.
So like this, it's better because here you know it's V and here will be the I, so it will be IV, which is over here. And
so actually for this you can put plus this thing, right?
Yes.
And I you can put it in front. Okay, so let me write this. Like this. Okay?
Yes.
Does it look much clearer?
So it would be IV.
Okay, so this is one of the examples, right?
Right.
So clear all this second thing.
Best is to don't use circle, cosine, cosine, sine.
So clear all this second thing.
Yes. As we don't pretend like there's a few numbers that actually tables, and nearly all, some of it have I, some of it don't have. So we just put it in different rooms, something like that. The
okay.
One group which have I with name V, and one that don't have I which name U, that I will be in front.
Okay, so next will be the Euler's
formula.
What is the tool that you can write?
Actually, we can use Z or theta.
Okay, what if we add these two together?
So usually these two will cancel, but we just look at one of the cosines.
Not usually. When you plus together, it will be canceled.
Yes, so we'll try and first just look at one of the cosines.
So remember, these two add together, because that is 12, this, yes. So these two add, right?
Yep.
E to the power. Okay, so that is a cosine, right?
So what if it was a sine?
So sine, you mean that
here must have an I as these two. So the denominator will need to be 2i. And the numerator between these two must be a negative now.
a tangent?
Yes.
So tangent
so will be two and two simplify. Two simplify, so the one is sign on top, so I put below.
So that will be for the sign up here, right?
Yes.
So here is the one that we get tangent, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, here, can we actually write it as a Z? So over here, this will be, okay, we'll write it as a Z, okay? Can?
Yes.
So that means all these theta will be Z.
For me? Okay.
Okay, change it to Z, right? So first, there's the inverse tangent. And then this thing. Oh, you don't need that bracket. Z, you mean? So down here there's an I, this thing. Okay, so we have this, right?
Yes.
Okay, well, what do we have next? Okay, well, right now for this, we can have, so we still have that inverse tangent, right?
Yeah.
So we also have this fraction, right?
Definitely.
So for this e to the power of iz, do you know what can happen?
It could be 2iz. You
one.
Know why?
Because then the numerator denominator times e to the power of iz.
Yes.
So down here also quickly. E to the power of 2iz, right?
Yes.
So like that. Next, can you let the let something be white?
Yes.
So here you have. Inverse tangent. Y sub in.
Okay.
And here you're right. Yes. Okay, so you get this thing, right?
Yep.
So can we erase this recall first? Is it okay?
Yes. And remember, we'll need to use maybe all of those.
this part. We'll need to first write this 1 over square root negative I in another way, right?
Yes.
So can you tell me what is negative I?
Negative I is e to the power of pi I times e to the power of pi over 2i, half pi I, which equal to e to the power of 3 half pi I.
So because that this is inside a square root, so you need over 4, right?
Right.
And because that it's at the denominator, so we'll have a negative.
Yep.
So for this I, it is the this, right?
Yeah.
So this over 2, which is pi over 4, I, right?
Yeah.
But remember, it is at the denominator, so you need the negative. This, right?
Yeah.
So next for this part, can we calculate out what is this using the Euler's formula?
Yes. So like just now, we use the Euler's formula.
So first for this, we have the cosine of negative 3 pi over 4, right?
Right.
But what is it?
Cosine negative 3 pi over 4? Is it? So it will be a square root 2 over 2 and negative.
Like this?
Yes.
Like this, is it right?
Correct.
But what about this part?
You mean about this part?
Here. What can this change into?
Cosine, which becomes a negative square root over 2 again.
Then here, here will be?
Plus square root 2 over 2.
Wait, what is this? So for this part,
so it's a minus, yes.
Like this. Like this, is it right?
Yep.
So right now for this, what can we have?
We could have...
Can we factorize things?
Yeah.
We factorize the negative square root 2 over
2
2. Okay?
So you need to take out. And don't forget, you also can take out the negative.
Yes, which is over here. Okay, so when we factorize, we can also separate and combine. Can?
Yes. We can separate this part and combine with this part, right? Right?
Wait. So here, like this, I have to separate, and then we have to combine with this. Okay?
Yes. We can take out the negative again, and you will do it in the next step. Can we take out the negative square root 2? You don't need to take out the half because they turn plus together.
But right now for this, these two, what happens? What happens? We can use the double angle formula for the tangent.
Yes.
Right? So it will be you need the alpha plus beta.
Yes, alpha plus beta.
Just alpha plus beta. Because that is actually the angle, right?
Yes.
So for that, you have the inverse tangent on top is the where is your tangent? That's the inverse tangent. It's tangent alpha plus tangent beta. So that will be the okay, are you sure?
Yes.
Okay, so over here we'll have the inverse tangent. Okay, so first this part, right?
Yes.
Then you have to plus this, am I right?
Yup.
So actually these two cancel and these two combine, right?
Yeah.
But what happens at the denominator? So here we have the 1 minus, right?
Correct.
Then it has to be this times this. Am I right?
Definitely.
So actually these two times there's a 2/4.
Yes.
Like this, right?
Right.
But when this time's in the iron, I can cancel, right?
Yes.
So these two is the minus, am I right?
Correct.
When it is a minus, that means these two minus.
Yes.
Like this, am I right?
Correct. Oh.
So for this, can we calculate what is it?
Yep.
These two can't remember. Like this, right?
That.
So right now at this part, it is these two that cancel, right?
Yeah.
Then these two they combine. Then this part you have the, like this, right?
Yeah.
So then after that, you can, what about if it's negative?
Negative, pull it out. Pull it out. Pull everything out. Don't you need to take this negative out too?
Okay, wait, for this part, do you know what can happen? Or do we take that negative out too?
We should take the negative out too. And don't forget this negative, 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 positive, negative, negative, positive.
So for this, you have like this, right?
Yeah.
Is this part of your answer? Is this right?
Yes. Later, this will also be a real number.
Okay, this
but
is...
But since the question don't have any eyes.
Because then the question is a real number, so the whole answer, it can only be a real number, right?
And don't they just pick
number.
Up...
It is called a real function, okay?
Yes, and don't think just take out this I and simplify. That's wrong. We still need to do something else.
Okay, but this is just one part of the real function, right?
Yes, a part of you.
So, do you know what can happen to this part?
What? It above.
So for this, to make this part easier, do you still remember about this?
Yeah.
So we can let something.
Let y.
So this can be this part, right?
Yes.
So for this part, the y minus 1 over this. Can we this part times and this part times?
Yeah.
And this I times I, which is a negative 1. Like this, right?
Right.
So this can move here, or these two move to the other side, right?
Yeah.
So let me arrange this in order. So like this is a right?
Yeah.
Okay, so we found what is this y, right?
Yes.
What do you think z is? Can we use the one from here?
Yeah.
Both sides long?
Long?
Then here you have the extra 2i, right?
Yeah.
So divide it here, right?
Right.
So this will be, remember there is an extra I?
Yeah.
So there will be the extra negative. So like this, is it right? Then for this part, you won't have the inverse tangent, right?
Correct.
This, is that right?
Right.
So is this our answer?
Yes.
Okay. Here is a negative, so you just need to reciprocal this one, right?
Correct.
So see, this is the general case, right?
Yep.
So what is so special about general case?
General case? You can do anything in general case. Plus, you're using a lot of methods. You're harder than special case.
Okay, so these, the general case, as you said, is a lot harder, right?
Yes.
And it can also be quite complicated, right?
Yes, we use more method in general case and less method in
case. In this case, for example, all of these we already have used, right?
Yeah.
I also have this let, right? The substitution, right?
Yes.
So we actually use quite a number of these methods, right? We also use our double
angles. Also, A minus B bracket squared, the tangent formula, alpha plus beta equals inverse tangent.
The tangent alpha plus tangent beta over 1 minus tangent alpha tangent beta, right?
Yes.
So we actually use quite a lot, right?
Yeah.
And you also have to be quite careful.
When you use more methods, you need to be more careful.
Yes.
As the working is more longer.
Okay. When it is complicated, you can get confused easily, right?
Yes.
Like, for example, this question. The complex number, there can be two ways, right?
Yes. And the five methods that we are going to use next time, we'll use the fifth method, is by gamma function.
Okay, and do you have anything that you want to say?
If you like our video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
Okay, so can we end our lesson here?
Yes.
Okay.
Next time we'll continue.
Okay.